Students, in the yesterday's lecture, like in the previous lecture, we have already learned the effect of dielectric medium in between the plates of capacitor. When you are placing a dielectric medium in between the plates of capacitor, definitely its capacity increases. But when you are placing a dielectric medium in between the plates, it can occupy total space between the two plates, or sometimes it may not occupy the total space. If it is only occupying some portion, then, like for example, this is a capacitor plate and only a part of that is occupied by dielectric medium. It has thickness T and the separation between the plates is D. So in order to find out the effective capacitance for this, what you will do, simply you will use the equation potential difference V will be equal to E into D effective. And D effective is the separation, effective separation with dielectric medium and as well as the separation between the two plates. So V can be written as sigma divided by epsilon naught into D minus of T into 1 minus 1 by K, right? So sigma can be written as Q by sigma is Q by A. You can substitute that here. So effective capacitance will be Q divided by Q by A epsilon naught into D minus of T into 1 minus 1 by K. This is with only one dielectric medium of thickness T. If there are as many number of dielectric mediums, then you'll be adding on this T1 into 1 minus 1 by K1 minus T2 into 1 minus 1 by K2, so on. So this is the relation. Like if you have only one dielectric medium between the two plates, without any hesitation, directly you can substitute that thickness of the plate and effective separation and dielectric constant in this formula, and you can find out the effective capacitance between the plates. This is very simple way. But if at all you have a capacitor in such a way, the total medium between the two plates is being filled with two dielectric constants of dielectric constant K1 and as well as K2. And remember, in this case 1, first we shall see what happens with case 1 and then we will learn about case 2. So in this case 1, the dielectric medium is dividing the distance between the two plates, right? This is the total distance, it is D, and half of the separation is being filled, this is D by 2, filled with dielectric constant K1. And remaining half of the material medium is filled with dielectric constant K2. This is distance D by 2. Okay. So when you are dealing with this kind of situations, what you need to do is consider this total, like this total arrangement, you can consider it as two capacitors of different capacities. First, let me consider this has capacity C1. Let me consider this has capacity C2. So as the entire space is completely filled with dielectric mediums of K1 and K2 constants, the medium which is filled with dielectric constant K1, I am considering it as C1. Medium filled with K2 constant, I am considering it as C2. Now, if I am taking this and connecting it to a battery, right? You will be taking one plate, connecting it to the negative of the terminal, terminal of the battery, and the other plate, it will be connected to the positive. So one is positive and the other one is negative. As it is positive, what would happen? This becomes positive charge and here it will be negative, and here it will be positive, here it will be negative. So the total space gets separated in such a way, you have two capacitors. These two capacitors are connected in series. So point number one to be noted is, if the dielectric medium is separating the separation between two plates into two parts, then you can consider that as two capacitors connected in series. So I'll now take these two capacitors which are connected in series like this. First one has capacity C1, second one has capacity C2. And total, it has been connected to some battery of potential V. Now, what is C1 written as? C1 is equal to epsilon naught K1. A is area of the total plate divided by the separation of that is T by 2. That is C1. Epsilon naught A by D formula I am using here. Epsilon naught A by D is the effective capacitance of the capacitor parallel plate capacitor. So C1 can be written as epsilon naught K1 into A is area. Area is not divided here. It is A divided by separation between these two points. Separation between these two points is D by 2. Next, C2 can also be written as epsilon naught K2 A divided by D by 2. Right? Now, how are these two capacitors connected? They are connected in series. Therefore, C effective will be equal to C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. C1 C2 can be written as epsilon naught A into 2 divided by D whole square into K1 into K2 divided by epsilon naught A 2 epsilon naught A by D into K1 plus K2. Right? Now this and this gets cancelled. What is left over there? Finally, you are left with C effective is equal to 2 times epsilon naught A by D into K1 K2 divided by K1 plus K2. Right? Now, what is this epsilon naught A by D? Epsilon naught A by D is the actual capacitance of the capacitor. So, C effective can be written as 2 times C into K1 K2 divided by K1 plus K2. This is how you can find out effective capacitance between the if the total space is filled with two dielectric medium such that the separation between the plates is divided into two parts or three parts or four parts or any number of parts, each part which it is being divided, you should consider it as a new capacitor of different capacity. So if there are three dielectric mediums separated over here, then C1, C2, C3. All those capacitors will be connected in series. First write down equation for C1 and then C2 and then C3. As those all are connected in series, find out the effective capacitance by substituting C1, C2, C3 over there. This is very simple way which you can solve problems when the entire space is being divided into two parts or three parts or as many number of parts using the basic technique. Right? This is how when the two plates are separating, like the dielectric medium is separating the space between the plates. And there is another situation where, coming to case 2, in this situation, you have two dielectric mediums. One is K1 and the other one is K2. In this case, the separation is constant D as it is. Separation between the plates is as it is, but what is happening here, the entire area, it is A. Area of the plates is A. Because of these dielectric mediums, the area is divided into two parts. This is A by 2 and this is A by 2. Okay. So these dielectric mediums which you are placing in between the plates of the capacitor, those are separating the area of the plates. Now let us take this terminal connected it to positive of the battery. Let us take this terminal and connect it to negative of the battery. Obviously, this becomes positive sign and this becomes negative sign. Definitely here positive charge will be accommodated, and definitely here positive charge will be accommodated, and here negative charge gets accommodated. Now these two, the separation between these two is D. The potential difference between these two plates is also V. The potential difference between these two plates is also V. So you can consider these two capacitors. Like first one, it has capacity C1. I consider this as capacity C1. I consider this as capacity C2. C1 and C2, by the figure, you can tell that they are connected in parallel. So simply, I'll take these two capacitors which are connected in parallel like this. Overall, they are connected with battery. This is positive and negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. So point to be noted is, if the dielectric medium is separating the area of the plates, you can consider that they are connected in parallel. If the dielectric medium is separating the space between the plates, distance between the plates, then they are connected in series. Now these are connected in parallel, C1, C2. First write down capacity of C1. C1 is equal to epsilon naught A by 2 K1 divided by separation is D. Epsilon naught A by D. That is C1. Next, C2 is equal to epsilon naught A by 2 K2 divided by D. C1 and C2 we have got. Now these two are connected in parallel. So I can simply write C effective is equal to C1 plus C2. This is equal to epsilon naught A divided by 2D into K1 plus K2. Right? Or you can even write it as epsilon naught A by D into K1 plus K2 divided by 2. This is the effective capacitance between the plates. Okay? So remember that whenever the dielectric medium are separating the separation between two plates, you can consider them as connected in series. Individual capacitors of different dielectrics are connected in series. When you are taking two dielectric medium, and if they are dividing the total area into two parts or three parts or four parts, you need to consider them like they are connected in parallel. Write down individual capacitors capacity, and then finally find out the effective capacitance between the plates using the basic formulas of series and parallel combination. Students, let me tell you one more example so that it will be very clear to you, then we can solve some problems. Suppose if the dielectric space, if the space between the plates is filled with air medium, capacity is epsilon naught A by D. Okay. If the entire space is filled with dielectric constant with K, then C is written as epsilon naught A K by D. So C dash will be equal to K times C. Capacity increases by K times if the entire space is filled with dielectric medium. Suppose if you have the entire space filled with two different dielectric medium, K1 and K2, you can consider this as capacitor C1, this as capacitor as C2, whose capacity is C2. And these two capacitors, as the separation between the plates is divided into two parts, you can consider these two capacitors as a series. So this is one capacitor, this is another capacitor, and these plates are connected with battery. Okay. So when you are connecting this with battery, you can find out the effective capacitance between the plates, just like how we have done in the previous part. Based on above, based on the concepts which we have learned, we will solve one simple example. With this, your all doubts will be cleared. We have a capacitor. This is plate one and this is another plate. The entire space between the two plates is filled with three dielectric mediums, K1, and the other one is K2, and the other one is K3. Three different mediums are being placed over here of different dielectric constants. First dielectric constant is dividing the area into 2a by 3 part. Okay. So even though in this figure it seems like it is half of the space, but it is mentioning area divided as 2a by 3. Okay. So looking at the figure, don't consider that as a by 2. In the question, what he give, that you need to consider. So in this area is being given as 2a by 3. That means 2 by 3rd area is completely filled with dielectric constant K1. And remaining A by 3 part is filled with dielectric constant K2, separating the distance as D, and K3 separating a distance as D, then this total distance become 2D. Okay. Separation between the two plates is given as 2D because K2 is having a thickness of D. K1 is having a thickness of D. So total distance will become 2D. Right? Now, this is a figure. I have explained the figure. Now check it out. Figure 8 shows parallel plate capacitor of area A and a plate separation is 2D. The left 2 by 3 of the gap is filled with material of dielectric constant K1 is equal to 4. What is given to you? Dielectric constant K1 is equal to 4. The top right A by 3 is filled with material of dielectric constant K2 is equal to 6. The bottom right half is filled with material of dielectric constant K3 is equal to 3. We have three dielectric mediums. Their values are being given to you in the problem. 4, 6 and 3. Remember, this is very important model. Often this kind of problems are asked in JEE mains and advanced. So K1, K2, K3 values are given. You should find out the effective capacitance. C effective is equal to how much? In order to find out the effective capacitance between the plates, first you should identify how many capacitors are connected with different dielectric mediums. Now let me write down different capacitors over here. See, as this space is filled with dielectric constant K1, it will have one capacity. I am considering it as C1. And the medium which is filled with dielectric constant K2, I am considering its capacity as C2. And the other one I am considering it as capacity C3. Okay. Now, I already told you, if the area is divided, you need to consider them as parallel. If separation distance is divided, you need to consider them as in series connection. Okay. So how can I redraw the circuit? First, let me write down equations for C1, C2 and C3. I'll write down equations for C1, C2 and C3. Now, C1, first capacitor's capacity, C1 is equal to epsilon naught. What is its area? 2A by 3 epsilon naught A K1 divided by separation is 2D. Okay. So, this is equal to 2 epsilon naught a k1 divided by 3 to 6 d. This gives you 3d. Okay, that is C1. C1 we have got. Next, write down equation for C2. C2 is equal to epsilon naught area a by 3 into dielectric constant is k2 divided by distance, it is D. Okay. This is equal to epsilon naught A K2 divided by 3D. That is C2. Next, C3 is equal to epsilon naught. Area is A by 3. Constant is K3 divided by separation is D. It is epsilon naught A K3 divided by 3D. C1, C2, C3, all the values we have calculated in this. Okay. Now, redraw the circuit, how these capacitors are connected. You can redraw the circuit, right? C1 is connected in series with C2 and C3. So, first I will draw the circuit here. Let me consider its capacity is C1. C2 and C3. C1 is connected in parallel with C2 and C3. You can check it up. C1 is connected in parallel with C2 and C3. C2 and C3 are connected in series. Check it up now. C2 and C3, these two capacitors, they are connected in series and it is connected to potential V and 0. Next, C1 is connected with potential V and 0. So C1 for it whole potential is V and 0. And for C2 and C3 overall potential is V and 0. But C2 and C3 are connected in series with each other. And C1 is whole connected in parallel with C2, C3. Now you can write down effective capacitance of C2 and C3 because these two are connected in series. Okay. Now, what is its capacity? You can write it as C2, C3 divided by C2 plus C3. That is the effective capacitance, right? Now, what is C2 and C3? It is epsilon naught A K2 divided by 3D. So, I'll write this as epsilon naught a divided by 3d whole square into k2 k3 divided by epsilon naught a divided by 3d. I'll take it common. It is k2 plus k3. This part and this part gets cancelled, and this as a whole is connected in parallel with C1. So overall effective capacitance will be equal to C1 plus C effective dash. This is C effective dash. Okay. Now what is C1 written as? C1 is written as epsilon naught a k1 divided by 3d plus, this is C dash. You can write it as epsilon naught a divided by 3d into k2 k3 divided by k2 plus k3. This is equal to epsilon naught a divided by 3d is common. So this gives you epsilon naught a divided by 3d into what is left over here? K1 plus k2 k3 divided by k2 plus k3. Fine. This is the final answer for effective capacitance. Now substitute k1, k2, k3 in that final expression. You will be getting one of these options, either a, b or c, d. Okay. K1 is given as 4, k2 is given as 6, k3 is given as 3. Substitute k1, k2, k3 values in this final equation. You will be getting effective capacitance of those capacitors. Let us solve one more problem which is of same model, and then we will go to the other topic. See, we have dielectric mediums k1, k2, k3 and k4, different dielectric mediums we have here, and the total separation between the plates is filled with these four dielectric mediums k1, k2, k3 and k4. Entire space is divided into four parts. The entire space between the two plates is divided into four parts. So as there are four parts over here, you can combine four different capacitors. Okay, so you can write down this capacity is a C1, its capacity as C2, its capacity as C3, its capacity as C4, right? So we have four different capacitors here, and it is already been mentioned how much separation they are, how much thickness this dielectric medium has and how much area they are been dividing. So as no area is been mentioned here, I'll be considering looking to the figure, I'll be considering this area as a by 2 and this area as a by 2. Okay, forget about this total. You are now supposed to find out effective capacitance of this total arrangement. So in order to find out the effective capacitance, we have four different capacitors here. I'll first write down capacity of each capacitor. First write down C1. C1 is equal to epsilon naught. What is its area? A by 2 epsilon naught A K1 divided by what is the separation? D by 2. That is C1. Next, write down C2. C2 is equal to epsilon naught. Area is A by 2 and its dielectric constant is K2 divided by separation. It is D by 2. C1, C2 values we have got. Next, write down C3. C3 is equal to epsilon naught. What is its area? A by 2 into dielectric constant is K3. Separation, it is 2D by 3. Right, and this is C3. Next, C4 is equal to epsilon naught. Area is A by 2. Dielectric constant is K3 divided by separation is D by 3. C1, C2, C3, C4, all values we have got. Just you simplify them. After getting these values, you need to redraw the circuit. How those capacitors are connected, you need to redraw them. Now see, C1 and C2 both are connected in series. C1, C2 is connected in parallel with C3 and C4. Okay, So I'll redraw the circuit like this. Two capacitors are connected in series, and the overall they are connected in parallel. So I will be redrawing the circuit this way. Check it up now. Here is V and here is zero. Now C1 is connected to potential V. I am considering this as V and this as zero. C1, C2 both are connected to V. Therefore, this is C1 and this is C3, right? Next, C1 is parallel with C2. C1 is series with C2. Okay. Don't get confused with this. C1, C2 both are in series. C3, C4 both are in series. C1, C2 is overall parallel with C3 and C4. Okay. C1, C2, C3, C4, all these values we have got. Now what you need to do, C1, C2, they are connected in series combination. So it can be written as C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2. These two are connected in series combination. You can write it as C3, C4 divided by C3 plus C4. Overall, these two are connected in series. So therefore, C effective will be equal to C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2 plus C3, C4 divided by C3 plus C4. All values of C1, C2, C3, C4 are already written here. Now take this C1, C2, C3, C4, substitute in this equation so that you can write down effective capacitance between the two plates. This is K4. I have written it as K3. You just change it. This is K4. Previously, I have written it as K3. That is K4. Substitute all these values, C1, C2, C3, C4. You will be getting the final effective capacitance for this combination. So students, we have learned how to find out the effective capacitance when different dielectric slabs are being placed in between the plates of the capacitors. In the past cases, we did not introduce battery. We did not take any battery connected for those. We have imagined potential difference and we have identified whether they are connected in series or parallel. Only that we did in the last two, three examples. But now, here, you are placing a dielectric medium in between the plates and you are connecting it to the battery, or you can disconnect the battery. Okay. So first we will learn what would happen. Introduction of the dielectric slab of some dielectric constant K in between the plates. And here we are dealing with case one, when battery is disconnected. When you are disconnecting the battery, what would happen? Now let us imagine that you have a capacitor plate of capacity some C naught, that is initial capacity. Now you are connecting this to battery of potential V naught. We have battery potential as V naught. This is plus and this is minus. Obviously you will be getting plus here and you will be getting minus here. Now, when you are connecting battery to this capacitor plate with some dielectric constant K, okay. So when you are placing this dielectric constant K over here and you are removing this battery connection, right? Now, as we know, when you are taking the when you are taking initial capacitor, let its capacity be C, right? Let initial capacity be C, and with the dielectric, or let me consider it as C naught, with the dielectric, what would happen? It will become C dash, which is equal to K into C naught, where C naught is the initial capacity of this capacitor. As you are introducing dielectric constant K here, what would happen to its capacity? Its capacity increases. Okay. Now you are already connecting the whole capacitor with battery, and that battery has potential V naught. Therefore, What will be the potential difference between these two? Definitely it will be V naught, right? So let me write Q naught comma C naught comma V naught comma E naught and U naught are, what are these all? See, charge. Q naught is charge, C naught is capacity, and V naught is potential. E naught is electric field. U naught is potential energy of charged air capacitor. This is, remember, these all are the values for charged air capacitor. Air capacitor in the sense there is no dielectric medium. Now, when you are placing dielectric medium, what would happen to all these terms we should now identify. And you are removing the battery, already its potential is V naught. Air capacitor has potential V naught. Initially, its potential is V naught. So you are not placing any dielectric medium here. Now, what you are doing? You are removing this battery connection and taking this capacitor which is being charged, and now you are introducing dielectric constant K. Okay, so here without dielectric, these all values are without dielectric medium and it is being charged to potential V naught. Now you are disconnected. This is disconnected with battery. Now after disconnecting, you are replacing, you are filling this total medium with some dielectric constant K. Now what would happen? What happens to its capacity? Capacity C dash will be equal to epsilon naught AK divided by D, which is equal to K times C naught, right? So C dash is greater than C naught. This is number one. What would happen to its capacity? Capacity of the capacitor would be increased if you are placing dielectric medium in between the plates. That is a C dash. Next, what about Q dash? Charge. Charge Q dash is equal to, what is charge? Q is equal to CV, right? So that is C dash into, what is its potential? Potential will be slightly decreased, is it not? Potential will be V dash, right? So as C dash is K times C naught, V dash will be V naught divided by K. Remember that when you are introducing dielectric slab in between the plates, what would happen to its potential? Potential would decrease. V dash is equal to V naught divided by K. So V dash is less than V naught. This is number. Next, charge K and K gets cancelled. So therefore, Q dash is equal to Q naught. This is number 3. So charge is conserved. Remember that charge is conserved. Charge is conserved. Next, we have calculated Q naught. We have learned what happens to charge, what happens to capacity, what happens to potential. Now write down equation for electric field. Electric field E is equal to sigma divided by epsilon. Is it not? Sigma is equal to Q naught divided by A into epsilon, can be written as K into epsilon naught, which is equal to E naught divided by K. What is happening to electric field? E is decreasing, E is less than E naught. Is it not? E naught will be equal to KE. So electric field is decreasing. Next, what would happen to potential energy? Potential energy is equal to Q square divided by 2 C dash. What is Q? Q and initial charge is however same. This is Q naught square divided by 2 times What is effective capacity here? Effective capacity will be C naught into K. This is equal to Q naught square divided by 2C naught into 1 by K, which is equal to U naught divided by K. That is, potential energy U is less than U naught. This is number 4 and this is number 5. Clear? So remember that when you are disconnecting the battery with air charged capacitor, its potential, and you are filling it with dielectric medium, its potential decreases, capacity increases, charge remains conserved, electric field decreases, potential energy also decreases. These are very, very important points you need to remember. So once again, I am repeating, charge always remained conserved. Charge will not be either increased or decreased, because after charging the capacitor, you are just removing the battery. Okay. So now there is no battery in order to charge it. What you are doing, just you are replacing the total space with dielectric constant K. Therefore, charge will remain constant. Charge is conserved in this case. That's number one. When you are placing dielectric medium in between the plates, capacity increases, definitely. Capacity increases, charge remains same. Potential decreases, that we have learned in the beginning itself. And taking that Q, C and V, you can find out electric field and as well as potential. Electric field decreases, potential energy also decreases. Okay, only capacity will be increased. Remaining all factors except charge will be decreased when you are disconnecting the battery. Yeah, look here. So in case A, we have disconnected the battery and we have introduced dielectric medium. And in case B, in this case, what we are doing is, you are, without any disconnection of battery, you are filling the whole space between the plates with dielectric constant K. Okay. Now, obviously, when you are placing dielectric medium, what would happen to capacity? Definitely, it should increase. So, capacity C dash is equal to K times C naught. C dash is greater than C naught. This is point number one. Capacity increases. Next, what about potential here? V dash is equal to V naught. Since battery is not disconnected. As battery is not disconnected, the potential difference with the dielectric medium or without dielectric medium will be always equal to the potential of the battery. Therefore, V dash is equal to V naught, that is number 2. So, potential remains same. Potential remains same. That is number 2, right? Now coming to charge. Q dash is equal to C. Q is equal to CV. So it is C dash V dash. What is C dash? C dash is equal to K C naught. What is V dash? V dash is equal to V naught. This is equal to K into what is C naught V naught? Q naught. Therefore, charge increases. Remember this. In the previous case, charges remained constant because charge is conserved as there is no battery. But now what you are doing, you are not disconnecting the battery. Therefore, when you are placing dielectric constant, its capacity increases. So in order to maintain the potential difference of capacitor plates constant, charge will be increased on the plates. Therefore, Q dash is greater than Q naught. This is number 3. Fine. Next. Now coming to electric field. What would happen to electric field? E dash is equal to sigma divided by epsilon. Sigma can be written as initial charge. Sigma will become now. See, as charge is increased, what you will get here? Q dash divided by area is A. Epsilon can be written as K into epsilon naught. What is Q dash? Q dash is equal to K into Q naught divided by A K epsilon naught. K and K gets cancelled. this is equal to Q naught divided by A epsilon naught, which is equal to E naught. Therefore, E dash is equal to E naught. This is number 4. Electric field remains constant. Electric field is constant. Next, last one is potential energy. U dash is equal to Q dash square divided by 2C dash. What is Q dash? Q dash is equal to K into Q naught. K square Q naught square divided by 2 into K into C naught. This K and K gets cancelled. It is K into Q naught square divided by 2C naught, which is equal to K times U naught. Therefore, U dash is greater than U naught by a factor K. This is number 5. Right? So in this case, what are remaining constant? Electric field is remained constant and potential difference is remained constant. Remaining all factors, capacity increases, potential remains same, and charge increases, potential energy also increases. So these are the comparisons when you are placing a dielectric medium with battery disconnected and with battery connected. See, we have now learned two cases when battery is disconnected and the battery is connected. And we have compared all those values, charge, capacity, potential, electric field and potential energy. What you'll do is you just take all the terms, charge, you prepare a table, charge, capacity, potential, electric field and potential energy. Now in the next column, with battery disconnected, with battery connected. What would happen with battery disconnected? What would happen with battery connected? You prepare a table and you once compare those. So once if you write these all things in the form of a tabular form, like in the tabular form, then the comparisons become equal and in solving problems, you can use them directly. So I request you to make one table. What happens to charge, capacity, potential, electric field and potential energy with battery disconnected and battery connected.